Once upon a time, there was a boy named Little Timmy. Little Timmy was in fourth grade and attended the city's public school. Little Timmy had an older brother named Big Tony and a younger sister named Tammy. Little Timmy and Big Tony loved watching action movies. Their favorite movies were the James Bond series because they loved all the cool fighting scenes. They would come home from a long day at school and turn on a good movie and watch it all night long. Another thing that the two brothers loved was playing video games together. Little Timmy and Big Tony would play against each other in Call of Duty, and more recently, their favorite game was Grand Theft Auto. The mother didn't think much of these video games because she figured it was alright if they only did violent things on TV and not in real life. But what was happening was that these kids were being taught to use violence to solve their problems. As these boys figure out how they're going to fit into the world, they'll either feel like they are useful or like they're not able to fit in. If they feel like they won't fit in, the chances of them resulting in violence is much greater. Little Timmy didn't have any issues going to school, and he got along with most of his friends. He really enjoyed things like playing basketball and foursquare at recess. A lot of Little Timmy's friends were jealous of him, because none of their moms would let them watch violent movies or play those types of video games. Those parents didn't want their kids to grow up thinking the social norm was to always fall back on violence. One day, Little Timmy was playing basketball with a new ball he had gotten for his birthday recently. It was a nice new ball and had new grip, and the word Spalding was cleanly written across it. A couple minutes into the recess, he shot the ball off the backboard, and it bounced toward another court. Little Timmy went to retrieve his ball when one of his classmates picked it up and claimed it was his. Although Little Timmy's name was clearly written on it with Sharpie, his classmate would not give the ball back. Without really thinking, Little Timmy ran up to the kid who was holding his ball, punched him in the eye, and took his ball back. Unlike the movies or video games, things did not work out in Little Timmy's favor. Shortly after the incident, he was called to the principal's office, and his parents were also called. Little Timmy had to write a letter of apology to the kid he had punched, and he spent the next week of recess inside cleaning up the classrooms. Both Little Timmy and his parents learned a valuable lesson in all this. Little Timmy wasn't allowed to watch violent TV or movies with violence in them. His parents realized that when he watches how violence works out for these characters in the movies, that the idea of violence is the answer is getting planted into his brain. Although Little Timmy isn't a violent kid, in certain situations, when he isn't sure how to react, his first instinct will be to use violence. These days, Little Timmy isn't so little anymore. He's now 34 and he has a good job with a growing family. Something like watching violent movies didn't have a lasting effect on his life since he was surrounded with good people, encouraged him to make better choices. Since Timmy learned his lesson at a young age that violence doesn't make things right, he didn't suffer serious consequences from learning his lesson. His older brother Tony wasn't so lucky. Unlike Timmy, he didn't learn his lesson until an older age when he got charged with aggravated assault for beating up a fellow employee. Tony then fell into a terrible cycle of going in and out of prison for various violent charges. Little Timmy could have ended up like Tony, but since he learned at a young age that violence doesn't solve anything, he was saved from a lot of trouble. Tony never really understood, morally, what he was doing was wrong. He was just trying to do things without getting caught.